Okay, so how does this work? Let me see. No. Right, anyway. Hello everyone. This is the camera, the ultrasight. So let's open it really quickly. And I'll try to answer also any questions you may have. We're going to use these two. Okay. It comes with some small cables, but let's make them a little bit better. And so for now, I'm not going to use the heatsink, but it is recommended to use it. For safety reasons, especially if you want to increase the output power. I will be using, though, a fan, and hopefully everything will go okay. Okay, so first thing, let's add some soldering. Hope you can see that. So this will be a little bit quick, just to update it. Normally you should add some more or cut the wire according to how you like it. And I have already created a flight controller and a 5 volts power supply for the camera. This one comes directly from an external power, which is 16 volts, something like 4S battery that goes from the flight controller directly to these two pins and then to the back. So we'll have 5 volts in this one, and we are going to connect them. Black with black, red with red, right? Okay, like I said, this is going to be a very quick soldering, but normally you should be very careful and make sure that you have good soldering connection. Just for demonstration. Okay. Next thing is we are going to connect the camera. Remove the protective. So this metal part is up. That means it will go like that into the slot. Like so. So you should be very careful to first align it, right? And gently with your nail, your thumbnail, gently press it one from one corner and slowly to the other. And once you are sure that it's well inside, just make sure to with your finger, your thumbnail. You want to have really good connection, yeah? Okay. And then always use antennas for any VTX, not just like this, not only for this, for any VTX. Never ever power up a VTX, analog or digital, without antennas connected, because all this power will go back into the chip and we'll burn it. So these antennas are the very basic antennas, of course, that comes with the camera. You can connect any other antenna you would like. It's up to you what you want to go, what you want to do. For a short distance, like 500 meters at least, these antennas are more than enough. But if you want to go 10 kilometers far, you would need something much better, much bigger. You want to make sure that you align it and gently press it, rotating it, so you can hear this click. Both needs to be in. Okay, and now the cable, the ribbon cable, and that is for the debugger, this one. This one will give you internet so you can update your camera, and also there is a debugger from this USB-C. You can connect it directly to a console, Linux or Windows or any other operating system, and you can debug the system if you know how to do it. But that's a little bit more advanced. We're doing now the very basic setup now, okay? Okay, connected. So the blue side is up. You should always look the blue side on both ends. Both ends needs to be to look at the blue side. Yeah, and that's it, the connection. And now, like I said, we should always use a fan when you will do testings over the bands. On the bands, sorry. Let me move the camera a little bit more. There we go. Okay. So we will be using here somewhere. It's my Radxa ground station, the VRX basically. But I have connected it to a monitor. Okay. And let's power up the fan, maximum. And have it directly hit the board. And I will connect the internet. And lastly, the power supply. We should be able to see a white LED blinking. Yeah, I can see it. That means it's powered up. But now we need to set it up, okay? So I'm going to use the configurator for that. And what we should do is just we click this button, firmware update. First we need to add the IP of in order to find the IP, you can scan the network, and then here you will add the IP of your camera, and that depends according to your network, so I cannot comment on that. It depends on any individual network, the IP that you will find. Anyway, so you click firmware update and then you type yes and enter again. Okay, so before this, the latest firmware, we have a different name of you can see that this is a different name. So if that happens, it will not upgrade. And in order to solve this problem, you need to go manually . You type the IP and then root. One, two, three, four, five. And I have already the command ready. I will put it in the video description if you want to see the command, how to resolve the problem. Okay. So with this command, when you hit the enter, then you close this, okay? And let's try again. Enter. And now you can see that this has changed. It's not anymore like the previous one. And it proceeds, it keeps going for the sys upgrade. It will take some time, just let it do what it has to do. You should not close this window, you should not disconnect the internet. Don't touch anything, just let it do its thing. Now it's erasing the partitions now. In the camera. And that's it. And now it rebooted. So we can close this window. And I have already produced a drone key on my Radxa, and I transferred it by clicking this command and then receive drone key. We generate key first in the Radxa. We click this button, we generate the keys, and then we click this button to receive the key, the drone key, and then we go to the camera, OpenIPC camera, and then we send the key. Yeah, it changed the IP. Send drone key. Yeah, and now it's sent. I have also created a backup of my settings, the settings that I want, but you can also modify and edit. You can use any settings you like from these menus. You can download the OpenIPC configurator and see all the settings and the options, the available options. But once you finish with and save them, once you save the options that you want, all the settings, then you hit upload, and you can see that they are being sent to the camera. And then you reboot. And if you see now on the screen, we have video. Okay. So basically that was it. And now we power off the camera. And we disconnect everything. Okay. Okay, let me see if I can see any questions. Live chat. Any questions? Can't wait to receive. Yeah, they are on their way. All of them, they have been sent. And yeah, that depends on when you live in the world. So it might take a short time or a longer time. However, now that we have established all the bank arrangements and agreements, it is going to be much quicker for the future cameras, because they are about to come two new models, the Mario camera and the Thinker camera. So those two cameras will be sent and received by the users much, much quicker on the next batch. Okay. Welcome, Sterling Paul. Thank you for your message. Hola, Sema Dragoon. Okay, so I see there are no any questions. I'm happy to answer any other questions after the live ends. So yeah, let's wrap it up for today, and feel free to ask any further questions once you see the video. Okay, thank you. Bye.